Dear students, today we are discussing about representation of a complex number in argon plane. Okay, argon plane is nothing but x-axis and y-axis. That means we can represent a complex number in x-axis and y-axis. So, what is the standard form of a complex number? A plus IB. A plus IB is called the standard form of the complex number. Here A is called real part and B is called imaginary part. Okay, so for example, here I am taking, so represent the complex number 2 plus 3i in argon plane. What is the meaning of argon plane? Argon plane is nothing but x axis and y axis. Okay, so let us consider x-axis and it is the y-axis. Okay, so 0 then I'm waiting first, what is it, 1 2 3 4, and so on. Here 1 2 3 4, minus 1 minus 2 minus 1 minus 2, it's clear. It is x-axis and y-axis, is nothing but argon plane. Next, dear students, let us consider a coordinate. Okay, now A coordinate, so whatever the real part here, 2, so that's why you can take 2, and you have to consider imaginary part is equals to 0, and B vertex. So first of all, you have to consider the real part is equals to 0 and imaginary part is equals to 3. Now the point, the order form of this complex number is becomes 2, 3. P of 2, 3 is called the order form of the 2 plus 3 complex number. Okay, we can represent it in argon plane. See here, first of all, whatever the A coordinate here, 2, 0. Okay, represent here 2, 0. A coordinate 2, 0. Okay, so on x axis. Next, whatever B coordinate, 0, 3. So 0, 3. Here you have to mark. So this is B of 0, 3. Okay. Next, see here, this region. Okay, this region. So point P of, so 2, 3. Okay, here the shaded region. Okay, region. So this one. So this shaded place is called up. So P of 2, 3. Okay, that means 2 plus 3 complex number argon diagram. It's clear, students. Next, here I am taking example number 2. So represent -2 plus 2i complex number in argon plane. Okay, so first of all, let us consider A coordinate is equals to, real part is equals to -2. You have to consider imaginary part 0. Next, B coordinate is equals to, first you have to consider 0 real part, next imaginary part is equals to 2. Now, okay, now coordinate system is becomes order form is -2, +2. Now you can represent in argon plane. Okay, let us consider is x axis and it is the y axis. Okay, I am marking 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. So -1, -2, -3, and so on. Okay, same like that, -1, -2, and so on. 1, 2, 3, 4, so on. Okay, see here, what about the A coordinate, -2, 0. Okay, okay, here you have to mark A point of -2, 0. Next, what about the B coordinate, 0, 2. So 0, 2, you have to mark to B 0, 2. Okay, or next, this place. Okay, so we are making point Q. So Q of, or you can take P, so P of -2, +2. This, okay, shaded region is called, okay, now, so the argon diagram of the complex number -2, +2i. Okay, this is the concept of the representation of a complex number in argon plane. Okay, okay, dear students, example number 1. Okay, show that the 4 points in the argon plane represented by the complex numbers, here given 4 complex numbers, 2 plus i, 4 plus 3i, 2 plus 5i, so 3i are the vertices of a square. That means we have to show that these four complex numbers represent a square. Okay, so first of all, I'm drawing a square. Okay, so first, dear students, first I draw this complex number as ordered form. So let us consider a coordinate or ordered form of 2 plus I is real part 2, imaginary part is equals to 1, and b coordinate is 4 comma 3, and c coordinate is 2 comma 5, and d coordinate is c students 3i. So here real part is equals to 0 and imaginary part is equals to 3. Okay, right. So write in here a coordinate, so 2 comma 1, b coordinate 4 comma 3, and the c coordinate is equals to 2 comma 5, d coordinate is equals to 0 comma 3. Okay, now we have to show that these four complex numbers are vertices of a square. Okay, what is the property of square? Four sides are equal, and so diagonals are also equal. That means we have to show that the four sides are equal and diagonals are also equal. Okay, that means simply you have to find the distance between AB, BC, CD and DE. Same like that, the distance of diagonal AC and the distance of diagonal BB. Okay, this is the concept. First of all, so first the distance of AB is equals to, what is the formula for the distance between two vertex x1 y1 and x2 y2? The formula is root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. Okay, see here, for AB x1 y1 x2 y2, here considering x1 y1 x2 y2, apply that formula, 4 minus 2 whole square and plus 3 minus 1 whole square. Okay, so it is equals to square root of 4 minus 2, how much? 2. 2 square is equals to 4. 3 minus 1, 2. 2 square is equals to 4. So therefore, we get 4 plus 4 is equals to how much? Root 8. So therefore, the length of AB is equals to how much? Root 8. Same like that. So the distance of BC is equals to root of. Okay, let us consider B and C vertex. x1 y1 x2 y2. Okay, 2 minus 4 is equals to 2, 2 whole square. Okay, and plus 5 minus 3, 2, 2 whole square. It is equals to 4 plus 4 is equals to much? Root 8. Okay, so the distance of BC is equals to much? Root 8. Next, the distance of CD. Next concept, the distance of CD is equals to, okay, so C and D, so x2 minus x1, 2 minus 0 how much? 2, 2 square is equals to 4, 5 minus 3 how much? 2, 2 whole square is equals to 4, so it is equals to root 8. So next, the distance of DA is equals to root of, so D and A vertex, 2 minus 0 how much? 2 whole square, so 2 whole square plus 1 minus 3 minus 2. Minus 2 whole square how much? So minus 2 whole square is equals to 4 plus 4 is equal to much? Root 8. See, dear friends, so the distance of AB, BC, CD and D all are equal. That means 4 sides AB equals to BC is equals to CD is equals to DA. Okay, first concept is over. Next, we have to check. So, two diagonals are also equal. Okay. So, therefore, the distance of AC is equals to root of A and C. 2 minus 2, how much? 0. So, 0 square is equals to 0. 1 minus 5, how much? 4. Okay. 4 square is equals to 16. The square root of 16 is equals to how much? 4. Okay. Next, finally, the distance of B and D. So BD is equals to, see here, 4 minus 0 whole square. Okay, that means 16 plus 3 minus 3 how much? 0. 0 square is equals to 0. root 16 is equal to so much 4. See students, the distance of the two diagonals AC and BD are also equal. That means AC is equal to BD. Yes, four sides are equal, diagonals are also equal. So that's why these four vertices are represent a square. That is the concept of square. Okay, dear students, today's homework is show that the points in the organ plane represented by the complex numbers. Write down 2 plus 2i minus 2 minus 2i minus 2 root 3 plus 2 root 3 i are the vertices of equilateral triangle. That means, okay, we have to show the equilateral triangle. The concept is you have to show that three sides are equal. Okay, that means AB distance equals to BC distance is equals to AC distance. Okay, okay, try this. Next, second problem. Show that the four points in the argon plane represented by the complex numbers minus 2 plus 7 i, minus 3 by 2 plus 1 by 2 i, 4 minus 3 i, comma 7 by 2 of 1 plus i are the vertices of a rhombus. What is the concept of rhombus? So, this is a diagram of rhombus A, B, C, D. First of all, we have to consider the four vertex: A vertex, B vertex, C vertex, and D vertex. Here, the property is four sides are equal. We have to show that four sides are equal, but diagonals are not equal. Diagonals are not equal means AC is not equal to BD. Okay, so try yourself. So,